floor. Welcome down. It's a nice floor. Good and sturdy. Keeps me grounded. But welcome to an opening fan gift video thing. I didn't go to a convention to get gifts, if any of you are wondering, like, where the hell did you get all that? It's from tour. When we went around Europe, a bunch of people gave us a lot of stuff throughout each city that we went to, and I have a box of stuff here. Not all of it is here. There's still a box full of letters and everything that I won't be going through in this video. As I always say, the letters are more of a personal thing that people write specifically to me, so I'd rather read them in my own time, and a couple of stuff that's attached to those, but this is a box of... There's a lot of stuff in this, but it's not everything, so I just wanted to go through some of this to show some of my appreciation for the things that people gave to me along this trip, because there's some really, really fantastic stuff in this, and really, really fantastic stuff that's not going to be in this video, and I really do appreciate it. It was very sweet of you guys to give us so many gifts, and then there's some other stuff that I took pictures of and everything. It's a big old hullabaloo! It's kind of hard to bring around all the gifts whenever you're going on tour, because you're on a bus, and you only have a finite amount of space, so I'm going to get to whatever I can in this, so bring in the box! Alright, first things first, it's Spider-Man, baby! Somebody didn't give this to me, it was a thing that... I talked about it before, how when you go on tour, you're allowed to ask for something that'll be in the green room whenever you get there. It could be anything at all. People ask for food, people ask for things. I jokingly asked for Spider-Man. I asked for pins and Spider-Man. The pins were a thing that I actually started collecting on my jacket. I posted about them as well from each country. So each country I went to and each city I went to, I had a different pin for each venue. So I'm going to put them all on a board at the end, and then I'll remember that from that specific version of that tour. But I also jokingly asked for Spider-Man because I wanted Spider-Man to show up. So some places gave me little plushies of Spider-Man. So that explains this, like, go Spider-Man! And yeah, also that would explain the Spider-Man hat for any of you wondering. I can't put two hats on. What is this, Crazy Town? Somebody made me the coolest little bud. They made me Bud from Grow Up or Grow Home. Isn't it so cute he has a little bud on him? Oh man, I love this little guy. He's so fucking cute. But if only I had Sophie the Klein. And I think they might have 3D printed this. I'm not sure. It looks like it has some of the marks of a 3D printer on it, which is just so fucking cool. Man, I don't know if these are actually a thing that you can buy, but I'm just so happy that I have one. He has so many different points of articulation. He can't stand up. He doesn't really stand up too well on his own, but just like Bud from the game, neither does he. He has trouble walking around as well, but really freaking cool. If I could just sit you like right there. There we go, me and Bud. I'm afraid to move his hands or anything. Blast off, Bud!
Hiya, Georgie! What a nice boat. Do you want it back?
This is something somebody put in the box. And I don't know if it was for me or for Aaron and Danny. I don't know, it ended up in my box. And I freaking love it. He's going on my shelf. A little tiny Pennywise, little hair. And he's got these little balls on his feet. I know what they are. They look delicious though, and I want to eat them. But really cool, he's got Georgie's little boat with him. Another one of my precious friends! This was adorable because I pulled this little guy out of the box, and everyone was like, oh, so cute! And then I was like, wait, there's something on the back. Then everyone just let out a collective, aww. And I just sat there all giddy holding Molly in my hand. He said other things. You okay? Did you say Eve? Yeah! I've never had a Wally plush before. I like that you can actually, like, move his eyes up and down. He's so freaking cute. Thank you for this.
Eva! Wally!
This is something I thought was really freaking cool. And something very, very expensive looking, which is a Ravenclaw pocket watch. It's fucking awesome looking. And then you can have it like this, and then you go, boop, and it pops out, and it's an actually fully functioning watch. How freaking cool is that? The time is not right on it right now. It says it's like 25 past 5. But, Jesus, really freaking cool. It's really well made, too. Like proper metal and everything. Thank you. Fellow Ravenclaws, unite! I'm kind of coming around to the idea of being a Ravenclaw. I didn't like it at first because I thought, ah, that's not Gryffindor. But now I'm kind of like, hell yeah, book smarts. We have a Jacksepticeye pillow. How cute is that? Very, very cute. It's so soft as well. Oh, look at the box. Trico, what are you doing, buddy? Somebody made this amazing Trico. Somebody who I've seen talk about it on Tumblr a bunch, and then they showed up at the Amsterdam show, which was the first show, and gave me a Trico. Look how fucking cute he is. Yeah, he looks like an actual like dog or puppy, just like, morph. Oh, you're so adorable. He's got giant wings, and he's so soft and fuzzy, and he's got a big long tail and big feet. You're so cute, Trico! My little Durkinder! Trico! I don't know where I'm gonna put you, because you're quite big, but I'll find a place for you, Trico. I'll find a place. Imagine if that was a real animal. Not like the full-size Trico, but this version of Trico. Imagine if you could have a Trico this size that would bound around your house. Like a little dog. I love it. Somebody made me a cross-stitch of sand and papyrus. To Jack, I hope you like it, from Sophia. Thank you, Sophia. I freaking love it. It's really, really well made. It's so awesome. I'm gonna find a place for this on a shelf somewhere, just to like prop it up, because it is in a frame with a back and everything on it. But thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Somebody gave me Pokemon Sun and Moon trading cards. I don't do anything with Pokemon trading cards anymore, but I definitely appreciate them. It kind of takes me back to a time, because I remember when Pokemon cards first came out, and that feels like such a long time ago by now. It's like, yeah, wow, Jack, you must be really old. Yeah, I am. Shut up, kids. But yeah, I remember collecting Pokemon cards and being so obsessed with them back then, so this is a nice little nostalgia trip. Somebody give me a little tracer as well. I don't know what kind of tracer this is. It's like a mini pop vinyl or something. He focused. There we go. Come on, get over here, small heroes. Jesus, tracer. Somebody also gave me a little bobblehead Deadpool. Which is so cute. One eye is staying still, and the one on the other side, the one on this side looks like it's flying around, but the other one is perfectly still. What is that? That's bizarre. He's so cute, though. I love Deadpool. And I don't have a Deadpool pop vinyl, or if I did, I think I might have thrown it away, but this is a much cooler one. There's very few bobblehead pop vinyls, and I don't actually have any of them, so thank you so much for this. And the fact that it's a Deadpool one is even better. Maybe I should make him a tracer fight on top of Trico. Or him a Pennywise. Oh, look who we have in here. It's your boy, Auntie, ready to fuck some shit up. He's even got a tiny little knife. His body was weak! Can you imagine if I looked like this as I did the Anti-Septiceye stuff? How ridiculous would that be? Oh, he's so squishy. Also, his knife, it looks unassuming, right? It's actual metal. Like, if I poked someone hard enough with this, I could actually stab them. Which is amazing! Little Auntie. Let him glitch out all over the place. Oh, he's so adorable. Thank you, whoever gave this. That was one of the things to pack all the stuff down. A lot of the packaging had to be removed, so I don't have names on them unless they're pictures and have the names on them already, but thank you so much. Ah! Well, Cuphead and his pommel man like to roll the dice. These are awesome. They're a bit fuzzy. They got little fuzzles going on them, but they're freaking adorable. What do you call this? I know it's like felt, but I can't remember the style that you call it. But look at them. They're the best of buds. Hey, you know, if only the game wasn't so absolutely agonizingly, painstakingly brutal, I might be able to love you guys just a tiny bit more. But there's always a part of me that looks at them and is thinking, I'm suffering right now. But you guys can hang out beside Auntie. There you go. They're perfect for my shelf. Oh, and they're bringing out pop vinyls of Cuphead. Cuphead and Mugman. And they look really, really good. I need to get them. And the devil. Ah, yeah. Somebody drew me as Vivi. Or didn't draw me as Vivi, but drew Vivi in the style of Jacksepticeye with his little Septiceye staff. This is from Vicky. Hope you like the drawing. I do. I freaking love it. It's fantastic. I love the little green bubbles all around him. That must have taken forever. But it looks really, really nice. It's very fizzy. Because that was, people kept asking me on the tour who my favorite video game character was, and Vivi was always one to pop back up every now and then, just because I love Vivi so much. And Vivi's supposed to be like 8 years old in that game, in Final Fantasy IX, and he goes through such a transition over the whole process of the game, so I don't know, I just like him a lot. And the fact that Septiceye Sam goes perfect with it. People drew me as Cuphead again, a different type of Cuphead, and there's another picture in the back. Top of the morning to you laddies! What a badass I look. I look like I don't give anybody a care. I don't look like I pay any mind to anybody. This is from, Ellie. I couldn't read the Ellie, but then it says also known as Bub Ellie. Oh, that's cute. Thank you, Ellie. I really appreciate it. Wait, are both of these from the same person? They might have actually just been thrown into the same thing. Nope. This is from Victory Ave some... Oh, God. Sometimes it's hard to read the handwriting. Love from Rika in Portsmouth. Oh, this was a good one. I posted a picture of this from the PAX party where the Polaris people had a sign saying, can you give this to Jacksepticeye? Because then you can go to the photo booth and you can hold it up and ha ha ha. So I just took a picture with it because I thought that'd be hilarious. I didn't even hold it up the proper side of my head. I held it up the opposite side. From Zetli? I gotta read some of these. I'm sorry. And then under the caption on Instagram, I said, can you? Because can you give this to Jacksepticeye? So somebody printed it out and gave me this. This picture is from Mayor Space, and we actually took some pictures. They made one for Aaron and Danny as well, and they're fucking awesome. Thank you so much. We really, really appreciated them. I don't know if they uploaded the picture. We all took a picture with our versions of these, so look forward to that if it hasn't gone up already. I think they might have been uploading it, so thank you very much. Man, I almost gave all the credit for all these pictures to one person. Sorry, my mistake. Thank you, everybody. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look what it is. It's Scary Terry, bitch. A Nightmare on Scary Street. This is a really freaking cool poster. It's just a bitch at the bottom. Oh, bitch. I love that episode, it's so good. This is from Rick and Morty. For any of you who don't know or don't recognize the art style and the fact that he has testicles on his chin, should probably give it away because they hide testicles everywhere in that show. Testicles and penises. But he was supposed to be like Freddy Krueger, but he had a soft side as well, he had a family, and he said bitch after everything. Like, don't even trip, dog! Oh, bitch. So thank you for this. This is a big-ass poster. I don't know where I'm going to put it, but I'll try and find a place. Oh, speaking of posters, I think I know which one of these are. Yeah. We got kind of confused about this. Look at this one. Ready Player 3! It's me, Aaron, and Danny! Isn't that cool? Wait, I'll hold it closer so you can get a full picture of it. That's the same as playing games! This is from... Blue Dinner. It's supposed to be like Good Dinner? Blue Dinner. See if you gave a real name in the letter. From Dan Scarlett. Thank you so much. These are great. But the reason I'm saying that we got confused by them is that this thing said four Jacksepticeye. And then I opened it up and there was three of them. So I thought, one for me, Aaron, and Danny. And I was going to give them each one as well. But then there was one thing for Game Grumps and there was five posters of the exact same in that one. So we got a little confused by that. But hey, man, the more posters, the merrier. Maybe I should sign them and send them back and then you can sell them. I'm only joking, of course. But thank you so much. This is really good. Ah, yeah. This thing. This is so fucking awesome. It's a little Sam, but when you turn it, it makes a weird sound, by the way. It's a little stiff. There's a part of it that gets a little stiff. But he's like a salmon ocean. The motion of the ocean. Sam's on the wave. Sam's hanging 10. Isn't that cool? I've never done anything like this before. This is really, like, well made. So good job on that. Did you make this for some sort of class or something? I don't even know how you make these, but fucking awesome. Thank you. Hey, look. It says Undertale on it. How cute is that? It's got a little heart in the middle. Right there. Yeah. Well, you can read it backwards as well, but this is the way it's supposed to go. It's like a tiny little scarf. This picture comes from Tushon. Thanks for always making me smile. Love, Gabby. Look at that. Look how fucking cool that is. I'm trying to get it so you can't, like, see all the lights and everything. Isn't that so cool? Thank you, Gabby. I really appreciate it. It's fucking awesome. At Silver Lunarscape, Gabby Piper. Thank you so much. I love this because you can really tell the amount of effort that went into making it. So thank you. Oh yeah, this was really sweet of somebody to do from Jax and Shannon Bishop in honor of your first but not last UK tour. This is my own star. My own star on the Walk of Fame. Sorry, just hello, you can see yourself doubled up in there. My first star on the Walk of Fame. It says Jacksepticeye on it. And then underneath it says, well, you can probably read it yourselves if I can't read it backwards. It says, Jacksepticeye, on the occasion of the placement of your star on the Star of Fame database, 15th of October, 2017, presented by the Star of Fame Foundation. It's so fucking cool. I have my own star. I mean, not really. There's not a fucking star on the Hollywood Strip. Or is it Vegas? Where are the stars? I don't have my own Hollywood star in the pavement or anything like that, but this is like a thing to honorary that's not words. I don't know what I'm saying, so I'm going to put this up somewhere. This is the type of thing that if I had an office, this is like one of the incentives to get an office, is to just have a place where I can hang up all of this stuff. It'd be fucking awesome. I want to do that. I want to put these all in a really cool place to put them all together. This one. This was made by a very, very lovely girl who I met outside the venue. She was from Spain, I think, and she also gave me some coffee. But it's from Marilyn S. It's really fucking cool. It's me at the bottom, and you have Bill Cipher up here from Gravity Falls. You have Rick and Morty, you have Shadow of the Colossus, Last Guardian, you have an Oxenfree radio thing. Down here we have Sans, we have the boy from Limbo. It's a double up picture, there's a big one behind us. It's the boy from Limbo, Fran Bo, and May from Night in the Woods. It's really damn good. I love the colors in it. They're so vibrant and saturated. That's the kind of shit I love. So thank you for that. And I met her outside the venue as well. She was very sweet. Also got this lovely picture from Shiplock. Shuplock. I don't know how to pronounce your name. Sorry. I see you on Tumblr all the time. So thank you for this. You were at the Denmark show, I believe. I remember opening this up in the green room after the Denmark show. So thank you so much for this. I don't know if you were actually there or you gave them to somebody else to give to us. Because sadly, you don't know who's in the audience. But thank you so much. It's really damn good. I need an anime. Can I be in an anime already? I'll keep the hair green if I can be in an anime. Ooh, this one. This one. This is really fucking cool. I got this from... Oh, you're a good cookie, Jack. Thank you for making us laugh. From Asley Avro. And some of you might have seen this online already because I credited them and showed a picture of it. But I got this at the Cardiff show, which is a paper. You can't even, like, this doesn't even do it justice. This is like a paper 3D kind of thing. So I don't know if you can see that, but as I turn it, you can see that this is all layered. So there's like a layer of green paper, a layer of white, a layer of like different stuff to give a shadow and a background. So this is all layered paper on top of each other, and it's popping out of the frame to give it a 3D effect, which I think is fucking awesome. And this is another one of those things that when I opened it up backstage, everyone there was like, whoa. And Aaron was like, man, I'm jealous. I wish I had one of those. So thank you so much for this. It's really cool. Again, another thing that has to be hung up or go on a shelf or something somewhere. It's fucking fantastic. You even got like my little tattoo. How cool is that? I love this. Thank you. Oh, it's your boy. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Look at that. That's amazing. Thank you so much. I love the colors in it. I love the green, but then the blue around my face and then the strikingly blue eyes. It's fucking awesome, man. That's the kind of thing I wish I could do whenever we did anti stuff. I wish there was a way, well, obviously there is, but you have to pay a lot of money for a lot of very professional people to be able to come together to do like makeup and all that kind of stuff and then have really high quality effects and everything. It would be cool to do a more high budget anti kind of thing to try and get it to look something like this. Well, obviously me and Robin can try and do it together, but it's a lot of work on his behalf, and then it would take too long, and two of us are not really well equipped to do it, I think. All the love, Wick from Poland, but like in Denmark. Aw, thank you so much. Yeah, I do remember actually getting this at the Danish show as well. So thank you, Wick. Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it. This has to go up somewhere too. I love the little glitchy effects all over it. It's fucking awesome. Sorry, I'm staring at it again, but I should be giving you guys a little love. This also works in well with the whole Septicare thing that I said we were going to do. There's a lot of art here already. I'm already showcasing art. So thank you. This one's awesome. This one is so simplistic. And I don't know. I love the fact that this is all empty over here and it's just me staring off. It's like a well-framed shot. It's a well-composed shot, put it that way. Oh man, this had a letter with a 2. But I think the letter's here. It might be in the other box as well, because I think it fell out of the picture when I held it up at the place and then it got jumbled with some others, so I don't have a name on this. I have your watermark though. Sorry, I can't read it, but thank you so much for the picture. I really wish I knew your name. Thank you so much. This is really, really cool. I look up. Twins. Somebody got me a little Uncharted coin purse, I guess you could say, from Uncharted 4. I don't know what I can put into this, but I definitely want to use it for something. I'll put like, oh, there's even a slot for like a coin up here. I am a man of fortune and I must seek my fortune. That's what it says around the bottom here. Really cool. It actually feels like really well made too. Thank you. I love video game merch, so thank you. Oh, and last, but by absolute no means least, because holy shit, somebody gave me this at the Irish show. Somebody gave me an NES Classic Mini, which, for any of you who don't know, I have the SNES Classic Mini. I went to get some with Aaron when I was on my tour. We arrived in Minneapolis, me, Adam, who was part of the tour, and Aaron woke up at 6 a.m. to go to Target to get the SNES Classic Minis because they just came out the day we were there, and these had come out before that, but these came out and were extremely limited supply. Nintendo kind of fucked up their stock of it. They didn't make enough of them. They sold out immediately. They were gone, like super, super fast. And then Nintendo came out and said that they weren't making them anymore. So this is an extremely, extremely valuable gift that somebody gave me. And I feel horrible for taking this off somebody. Because these are worth like $300 on eBay now. So thank you so absolutely very much. I do not take this for granted. This will be played. I'm definitely going to be playing this. Because it's just so cool. And this is the type of thing that... This is so many games that I didn't get to play when I was younger. Growing up, everyone always had like an NES or an SNES. And it's always... Everyone always says that their favorite games when they were a child are like Metroid or Mario or Castlevania and stuff like that. At least people of my age when they were growing up. But I never got to play any of those games. And then the SNES Classic Mini and the NES Classic Mini, this one, came out. And it has all the games from back then that I never got to play. So I finally get to play stuff like Punch-Out and Super Mario Bros. 3 and the original Zelda and some Kirby adventures and everything. And then on the other one, I get to play Super Metroid and I get to play Mega Man X and Kirby's Dream Golf and all these games that I always wanted to play that I never ever got to play. So I'm super happy that I get to do that. Thank you so much for this. This really means a lot to me. And because this is the type of gift that it is, if you want this back, I will definitely give it back to you. I will definitely do that. I don't want to take this off somebody if this really means a lot to them, because you can't get these anymore. So if you really, really want this back, I absolutely appreciate the gesture, and I love it to bits, and I will play the shit out of it, but if you want it back, because I know how valuable this might be to somebody, and I feel horrible for taking it off somebody, if they really do want it, I will definitely give it back, so please try and get in touch with me and let me know. Otherwise, I will play the shit out of this! But thank you so very, very much. The gesture alone means the world to me. Okay, and that does it for this box. As I said, there are other things that I'm not going to go through right now. I just wanted to show off some of the gifts that people give me, because some of you are absolutely amazingly talented, and I can't believe I'm so lucky to be able to get these types of things. Not only am I lucky enough that I get to play video games all the time, but I get to tour Europe as a cause of that, and then people come out and give me such amazing gifts every time. I do not take any of this for granted. It means the absolute world to me. So thank you so very much for not only coming to the shows, but giving me such absolutely beautiful gifts that have so much heart and soul and time and effort just gone into them, and I can really tell how much all of this means to people, and I hope you know how much it all means to me as well. So thank you so much for the gifts. But also, thank you guys for watching this video. I'll be back again with more stuff like this whenever I get gifts that I get to open. I don't want these gift videos to be a thing where I'm like, look at the cool shit I have. I hope you realize that it's a case of me showcasing how grateful I am for the stuff that you guys give me, that I do receive it, that I do actually get these gifts, and it's not a case of me saying, thank you for the gifts, and then they're all in a pile somewhere back at the venue. I really do appreciate the gifts that people give me, because it's such a unique thing to be able to do, and I'm so incredibly lucky that I get to do what I do and have so many people look up to it, and it means so much to them. So thank you so very much. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, floor now. Thanks for hanging out. My ass is cold.